Okay, in this video, I just want to do some arithmetic basics, and what I want to do is just show you a little trick of how to convert a terminating decimal into a fraction. Hopefully the decimal you have to do this with doesn't have a long decimal expansion. If it does, it can be a pretty tedious endeavor, at least the way that I do it. So I want to show, for example, that we can write 0.5 as, well, 1/2. 1.75 is the fraction 7 over 4, and 2.88 as the fraction 72 over 25. So this is how I do it. So let's start with 0.5. The first thing I do is you can write any number. You can take any number and divide it by 1, and that's still the exact same number that you started with. And what I'm going to do is, on my 1, I'm going to add on a couple zeros. And what I'm going to do is, I want to get rid of the decimal in the numerator. Okay, so I'm going to get rid of the decimal in the numerator. So to do that, if I multiply basically the top by 10, and the bottom by 10, all I'm really doing is moving the decimal one place. That means I would have to move it one place in the denominator. So if I move it one place, and I move the decimal one place as well, I'm going to be left with the number 5 over 10. And now I just try to simplify this if possible. Well, 5 over 10, I can write 5 as 5 times 1. I can write 10 as 5 times 2. Remember, if you have all multiplication in the top and all multiplication in the bottom, you can cancel out common factors. And hey, that just simply leaves us with the fraction 1/2. Okay, so let's try 1.75. Let's try the same trick. Okay, so I'm going to write 1.75 over 1. And the idea is, if I move the decimal place twice, 1.75, you have to add on basically two zeros in the denominator. Okay, and remember, if the numerator of a fraction is bigger than the denominator, the original number you started with was bigger than 1, and that's certainly true. So just a little quick little check to make sure you're on the right path. The tedious part about this is just trying to really reduce it more than anything. So this is where you kind of have to know factors. Well, let's see, I think 1.75, I think about $1.75. Well, quarters go into $1.75, so that means we can multiply 25 by something. Well, I think we would need 25 times 7. That's going to give us 175. And then I think, well, how many quarters are in a dollar? There's 4 quarters in a dollar, so that means 25 times 4 is going to give us 100. And again, same thing, we can just cancel out the 25s, and we're left with simply the fraction 7 over 4. So plug 7 over 4 into your calculator, or better yet, convert it back into a decimal, and you'll see that you get 1.75 back. One last one, so 2.88. Same thing, I'm going to write this as over 1. If I move the decimal place to the right 2 times in the numerator, that means I'm going to have to add 2 zeros to the denominator. And okay, so again, now I have to start looking for common factors. Well, one thing, if they're both even, what I like to do, that means we can take 2 times something on the top. And if we divide all the numbers, we'll get 144. So 2 times 144 is going to be 288. And 2 times 50 is going to give us 100. So we can cancel out our 2s, and that leaves us with 144 over 50. But now the same trick. I think we can actually reduce this again. Notice both numbers are divisible by 2 because they're both even. Well, since they're both even, notice you can write 144 as 2 times 72, and then 50 as 2 times 25. So same trick, we can cancel out our 2s. We're left with 72 over 25. And now I think, huh, does this reduce any further? If you think about factors of 25, The factors of 25, the only thing that you can multiply whole number-wise would be 1, 5, and 25. And, well, you know, 1 doesn't really help in terms of reducing your fraction. 5 doesn't go into the number 72, and likewise 25 won't go into the number 72, so that means we've now reduced our fraction as much as possible, and it says you can write the decimal 2.88 as 72 over 25. So, alright, I hope these examples make some sense. Like I said, you know, I'm not going to do this one out, but if somebody gave you, you know, 3, 4, 7, 8, you know, a big number, it's going to be a little tedious to simplify it because you're going to get 1, 2, 3, 4, 7, 8, 9. What did we do? We moved it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So now you'd have to start reducing a big number like that. Yuck. I would not want to simplify that down. But, you know, I don't think in a typical class, you're not going to see these sorts of problems. If they do, tell your teacher that they're being bullies. So, all right, I hope this video helps you out and makes some sense. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to post them.